Well, hello once again, everybody. I'm Jeff, and welcome back to the gridiron. What we want to do right now, want to start previewing all the action in the NFC home games for week 9. Now, it's a little bit of a off-balance type of schedule. There's 4 teams who have buys this week. Okay, so that means there's 14 games. But out of the 14 games, only 5 of them are in the NFC. We got 9 AFC home games, so we only got 5. We want to start off with my key game, which is a rematch, okay, from a few weeks ago. Got Tampa Bay going into New Orleans. Now, remember, a few weeks ago, Tampa Bay, very impressive victory at home over the Saints. They prevailed 26-20. Right at the end of the game, Drew Brees had the Saints marching down the field, but I believe he got them down around a 5-yard line or so. Final play for him, I think it was 4th down. He was scrambling, rolling out to his right. He had some pressure on him. He had to throw the ball. I believe it was 4th down, so he had to throw it. Through the end zone, got intercepted. Tampa Bay comes away with the victory. Very, very impressive victory for the Bucs. Now, this one's in the Superdome, but the thing is that Josh Freeman has won both his games in the Superdome. He's played the Saints 4 times. He's won 3 out of 4 times, and 2 of them, his victory was in the Superdome, but that's not impressive. Now, the Saints are coming off a little stretch, little period here where they were playing teams with poor records, shall we say, except for the Tampa Bay game. The Saints, as we remember, the last 2 weeks they played teams that didn't even have a win. Didn't stop the Rams from beating the Saints last week, but the Saints, they beat the they played the Rams, then they played the Colts, then they played the Buccaneers, who had the winning record. But then before the Buccaneers, they played the Carolina Panthers, who I believe at the time had 1 win. And before that, they played Jacksonville at the time, who had 1 win. Jacksonville only won the 1 game at the time, the opening game victory over the Titans. But now the Saints, they're coming into a stretch here. Things are going to start getting a little difficult for them. Stretch here where I believe the next 5 opponents all have winning records. And some of them, let's see, they have Tampa Bay at home. Then the next week, they're going in Atlanta. Woo! What a big game that'll be. And I believe Atlanta should win this week, playing the Colts. So that'll make Atlanta 5-3. So that's going to be a huge game next week. That'll be for the division lead next week. Then they got a bye. Saints finally got a bye. Then the Giants come to town. Saints usually whoop up on the Giants pretty well. Brees usually has a field day against the Giants, especially in the dome. There's no weather conditions and nothing like that. He'll probably pick the Giants apart. Then they got Detroit coming to town. Then after that, they're going on the road in Tennessee. Tennessee's got a winning record, so Saints got a tough stretch here ahead of them. Be very interesting to see how they come out of it. But the Bucs also, they're playing in New Orleans, could possibly lose that one. Then they got the Texans coming to Tampa Bay. They could possibly lose that one. Then the Bucs got to go to Green Bay. So if the Bucs aren't careful, they can go from 4-3 to 4-6. And as I said, with the Saints, they got to be careful because they got a tough stretch here ahead of them, which also bids well for the Falcons, who sitting at 4-3, possibly should win this week. Okay, might be 5-3, and the Falcons start rising to the top. I got them going to the Super Bowl. I don't know if that's going to happen, but the Falcons are starting to rise back to the top. Now, very interesting game. We got, as I said, the Bucs have had success in the Superdome. It just, the numbers this year just aren't adding up for me. The Bucs have a winning record, but they've allowed 24 points a game. They've only scored 18 points a game. They've allowed more points than they've scored, and they have a winning record. The Saints, on the other hand, allow 23 points a game, which is not very impressive, but they've scored 32 points a game. They've averaged in their home games over 40 points a game they've averaged. Of course, the 62 points they scored against the Colts is a big help, in that factor. But the Saints can put up some points at home. Now, the yards per game, The Saints average over 100 more yards per game than the Bucs. Saints have 444 yards a game that they average, 444. The Bucs average only 340. All right, Bucs don't move the ball very well. Yards per game allowed, all right, the Bucs are giving up more yards than they're getting. They get 304 yards a game, they're giving up 391 yards per game. The Saints allow 346 yards a game, so you can't move the ball against the Saints, okay? But, you know, it's just not adding up. Now, with the game last week with the Saints, now, when you lose to a team like the Rams aren't that horrible, obviously. But when the team you're playing is winless, as the Rams were, and you're expected to win it, maybe not destroy the team, but you're expected to win the game. So when you go into their field and they wind up beating you and humiliating you, embarrass you, it does one of two things. One, it can expose you that, hey, we're not that good of a team. You know, the Rams did certain things and exposed certain weaknesses that the Saints have, and that other teams might start seeing these weaknesses and start exposing them, and the Saints might start, you know, coming back down to earth. I don't really see that happening. The other thing it can do is it can give you a cold slap on the face, wake you up. This is the NFL, which stands for not for long, when you keep playing football games like that. I think Sean Payton, he said he was obviously very disappointed. He put a lot of the blame on him and the coaching staff, and I think this week he's going to have the Saints up and ready to play this week. Should be a good game, but I'm going to give the nod to the Saints. I think they'll get back on their winning ways once again, which will set them up for that big game in Atlanta next week. Woo! What a game that should be. All right, well, now for the other four games we have in the NFC for week 9. Seattle going to Dallas. I think that Eagle game kind of gave the Cowboys a cold slap on the face. Shows you what the Eagles can do, okay, but shows you what the Cowboys need to step it up a little bit. I think the defense will step it up, okay, and I think they'll take care of business against Seattle. I don't want to give any type of predictions because, as we saw earlier in the year, Dallas had a huge lead to the Lions, and they wound up blowing it. So I think they'll beat the Seahawks. I think they'll take care of business. And then we got 49ers at the Redskins. Now, this is one here, one of them. It's like, man, the Redskins, Shanahan got shut out for the first time ever in his career. End of the game there. They had the ball deep in Buffalo territory. They could have possibly kicked the field goal and avoided the shutout. But he just, kudos to him. Your team needs a victory. Your team needs points. He went for the touchdown. They didn't get it, but as I said, he could have did away with the shutout by possibly kicking the field goal, but he had nothing to do with that, which wound up breaking his streak at like, well, over like 260 or 280 games. And he's coaching his NFL career, has never been shut out. That's remarkable. Absolutely remarkable. And I said, 49ers, you know, at home, on the road. The Redskins just got shut out. Redskins coming down, not looking too good and all that. Redskins at home. I'm going to pick the 49ers, but I'll tell you what, I wouldn't be surprised if the Redskins wind up winning this one. Wouldn't be surprised at all. Then we got the Buccaneers. We got the Saints. Take the Saints. And I got St. Louis at Arizona. Now, St. Louis, Arizona, whew, you're talking the bottom of the barrel down there with the NFC West. The Cardinals, especially last week, I mean, yeah, they gave up that big lead to Baltimore, and they lost, but they fought hard. They played a very good game. And coming home, as I said, they did, you know, they did well against the Ravens. I'm going to give the nod to the Cardinals. I think they'll pull it out this week against the Rams. And then we got the Monday night game, the Bears and the Eagles. Now, I'm a Giant fan. I got two favorite players of all time. One is Gale Sayers. The other one is Dick Butkus. I got my Dick Butkus jersey on, okay, for Bears. I think the Bears might need Dick Butkus this week to stop the Eagles. I think the Eagles are, and I went against the Eagles one time this year. Was when they played the Falcons. That one I was right. I picked the Eagles all the other times, especially when they lost. But picking the Eagles again, I'm a Giant fan. I love nothing better than to see the Eagles lose, don't get me wrong, but I'm on that Eagle band. I'm on the Eagle, the Eagle train. I got the wheels keep on rolling, baby. Now, if the Eagles don't beat themselves, they'll beat the Bears. And we saw it. See how many points, how many yards they can put up against a great defense. The Dallas Cowboys are a top-ranked defense. Eagles shredded it. Absolutely shredded it. Now, they can do the same. Now, Forte, what a guy. What a running back, I'll tell you what. Could have a good game, but I think with Trent Cole and Babin coming off the edges there, I think Cutler could have some pressure. And he could have some problems. And I think the Eagles, Bears got a great defense, don't get me wrong. But I think the Eagles, well, at home, I think they'll keep the momentum going, baby. I take the Eagles. So, 5 games, NFC, week 9. We got Cowboys over the Seahawks. I got the 49ers over the Redskins, but I wouldn't be surprised at all if the Redskins wind up winning. Saints over the Bucs for the lead in that division. Then I got take the Cardinals over the Rams in the battle of last place. And I got the Eagles over the Bears on Monday Night Football coming to you live from the lake in Philadelphia. Well, that's all time I have for right now. Thanks for watching. Next time I come back and see you, I'm going to start previewing the 9 games in the AFC for week 9. But till then, once again, thanks for watching. I'm Jeff and I'm going to see you on the gridiron.